Hello, my name is Jeff with Adash, and this is the DDS tutorial video. In this video, I would like to show you how to set alarm limits. There are three types of alarm limits which can be used in DDS software. We can set the limits according to ISO 10816 standards, or Adash limits, or user-defined alarm limits. The selection of the limits is always connected to the data cell. You can set up different limit values for various data cells. Let's start with the first, which are alarms according to ISO 10816 standards. We will work on the graph tab, where we can see the data preview. First of all, you have to define the ISO machine group to your machines. You cannot do that on the measuring point, nor on the data cell. Right-click on the required machine and select Properties. Go to the ISO 10816 tab and select the required machine group and its foundation. Groups 1 to 4 are described in the right window. See the Vibrio manual for more information about ISO 10816 standards and their limit values. Confirm by clicking OK. ISO 10816 standards are applicable only for velocity RMS data cells with a 10 to 1000 Hz range. Right-click on that data cell and select Properties. Go to the Limit tab, click ISO 10816, and confirm by clicking OK. You can see that individual measurements have changed color according to the applied limits. You can change the appearance of limits. Go to the Graph tab and click on the Trend Limits button to see lines or bars. Select Off to cancel the limit appearance. To switch off limit values, go to Data Cell Properties again, Limits tab, click None, and confirm by clicking OK. The second option is to set the Adash alarm limits. They are applicable only for two types of data cells, velocity RMS in the 10 to 1000 Hz range, and acceleration RMS in the 500 to 16 kHz range. See the Vibrio manual for more information about Adash standards and their limit values. The Adash alarm limits require information about the speed. You can set the speed under the required machine or measurement point. Right-click on the required machine or measuring point, select Properties, and go to the Speed tab. Enter the speed value and confirm by clicking OK. However, the speed measured by the instrument has priority. For the Vibrio M, the speed will be taken from the first screen auto speed detection or manual input. For the VA3 Pro or VA4 Pro, it is taken from the speed probe. To set the Adash alarm limits, right-click on one of the mentioned data cells. Click Properties, go to the Limits tab, select Adash, and confirm by clicking OK. Individual measurements will change their color according to the applied limits. To switch off limit values, go to Properties again, Limits tab, click None, and confirm by clicking OK. The last option is user-defined alarm limits. They are applicable for any static data cell. For these alarm limit values, you should determine vibration limit values according to your experience. Some producers of rotating machinery may provide permissible vibration values for their particular equipment. Again, right-click on any static data cell. Select Properties and go to the Limits tab. Now select the User option. Click on the plus icon and enter the first value for the warning limit. Click on the second plus icon and enter the value for alert. Click on the third plus icon and you can enter the value for danger. Double-click on any limit value if you want to edit it. Confirm by clicking OK and your limits will be applied. If you change the limit appearance to lines or bars, you can edit alarm limits manually by holding the left mouse button on any alarm edge and moving the mouse. The states named OK, Warning, Alert and Danger were predefined in DDS, but you can change those names according to your requirements. Go to the Tools tab and click Alarms. Select the required alarm, click Edit, and you can change the name and color of the alarm. So, this was the video showing how to set up alarm limits in DDS. Thank you for watching.